Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Australiana, give him a big welcome, John Williamson.
Dad came home on the booze bus, ringing in the pub all day. He rang Mum to tell her he wouldn't be long away. He told her not to worry, keeping dinner hot tonight. I've won the meat tray and the pool comp and I'm all right. Well, Dad's a real old bushy, says his mate that drove the bus. He helped Dad in with that side of lamb and he stayed and had a feed with us. Well, we were all in the packing shed after we had eaten. It was almost Christmas time, the work was barely beaten. When an old Italian neighbour, like he did last year, came with bottles of homemade wine and half a box of beer. Well, Dad and me got talking about the good times in the past, but once we opened that homemade plonk, we knew he wouldn't last. Well, I loaded the truck for market, it had to go in tonight. Filled her up with petrol and pulled the canvas tight. Then we all stood round and argued, the language was unreal. Dad swore and yelled me over, Mum, who do you think's gonna take the wheel? Dad's been selling flowers all his life, Grandpa grew him too. He's a well-known man round Flemington's, probably sold a bunch to you. Well, we followed a load of veggies off to Flemington as well. It lost a crate of pumpkins, but the driver couldn't tell. Dad drove ahead to tell the bloke we saved his Queensland blues. To show appreciation, he gave Dad another box of booze. Well, Dad really hated traffic jams, cause he had a Japanese kidney. Parramatta Road, I've heard him say, is the varicose vein of Sydney. Well, there was a Christmas do at the markets and the growers all got drunk. Dad climbed in to take us home and boy, the old man stunk. Mum slapped him hard behind the head, said, lie down in the back. Sam and I tied him down with an old tomato sack. Well, the cops pulled up the market blokes, going home with an empty load. They were putting them in that government bus along Silverwater Road. And they put the bag on Mum, but she hadn't touched a drop all day. And Dad was yelling something about Neville random tests of the cob as we drove away. Well, we had a pretty nice Christmas and Dad was sober too. Had a real long thing standing at the sink while he made Mum a pot of brew. Said, I'm going to stop this drinking. Could have been me that they locked up. It's too much to lose with me and the booze. Here, Mum, give us your cup. Dad's been selling flowers all his life, Grandpa grew them too. He's a well-known man round Flemington's, probably sold a bunch to you. He's been selling flowers all his life, Grandpa grew them too. He swore he'd never drink and drive, if he did he'd just have two.
Thank you. Dusty fans here, and I don't know if you know that or not, but everywhere Slim goes, he takes his big red cattle dog with him, and he calls him King Red. Did you know that? He's very large for a cattle dog, and that's why he calls him King Red. And the last time I saw Slim was in Tamworth, and in fact it was probably in the long yard, I can't remember, but and he had the dog with him, and the funny thing was though, King Red the dog was completely bald from head to foot. I said, Slim, what happened to your dog? And he said, mate, we've had a lot of trouble with King Red with the fleas. We've tried everything, you know, powders, washes, collars, sprays, nothing works. So in sheer desperation, he said, this morning, to give the poor thing some relief, we shaved him from head to foot so all the fleas would get off. Well, it was working. All the fleas were jumping onto my little black bitch. They were getting on pretty well, King Red being in the nude and all. And I put her in the back of the car, you know, and she's covered in all these fleas. All this sort of thing going on, and all of a sudden, in the back of my car, I hear this song start up. Now, you won't believe this. I turned around here, standing on top of my dog, is this flea He's about this high. He's got this little slim dusty hat coming over his head like this. You don't believe me, huh? He's got this little guitar about this long with one string, right? And he's got an awful look on his face and he's singing this song.
It's a lonesome away from King Red and all. By the campfire at night, he kept me quite warm. And I'll miss good old Slim, we've been everywhere, but there's no place for a flea on a dog with no hair. Now I found me a new dog, all shiny and black, and I found me a girl flea up here on her back. While poor old King Red is sunburnt and bare, it's no place for a flea on a dog with no hair. Now we live together, my girlfriend and me, and we get on well in the land of the flea. She came from Tamworth, all the boys knew her well. She lived on a barmaid of the Locomotive Hotel. Now I've lived on a duchess. Oh boy, that was weird. One night I awoke on Ralph Harris's beard. But I've got to get back, 'cause my heart is still there. I'll just wait for Slim's dog to grow back some hair.
Thank you. Oh. You itchy now? Can you feel that? Speaking of dogs, I read a book a few years ago called Dusty, which is a classic Australian novel. And they recently made a movie out of this book, and it's all about a little dingo pup that was found in a litter. And the story goes, a young bloke discovered this little pup and realised it was half red kelpie. So he took the pup down to the pub and conned an old stockman into a pound for this purebred red kelpie sheepdog, which of course was half dingo. And later on, after winning trials and everything with this dog, it started to go out and kill sheep at night. And of course, you know, in the bush, that's not supposed to happen. In fact, you're supposed to do away with the dog when he does that, but the old stockman couldn't do it, so he left his job instead. And it really is a nice little story about the man and his dog. But the interesting part about this story is that it's all from the dog's point of view. So this song, to explain the story, to understand it, you've got to imagine I'm a dog, okay? And it's called Just a Dog. Bloody flies. Hey, hounds need a job. And this one suits me fine. Rounding up the and keeping them in line. I'm just a dog, but I'm gonna break if you don't let the string go. And I will be your friend, and a friend is what you need to move a thousand, and you owe me a feed. I'm just a dog, but you don't know my mother was a dingo. And you don't know I like to howl at the moon. Just a dog.
running ragged round the edges in the evening, running high on the silver of the night. You're all a smoke, and I'll lie in the shade, waiting for you. I'm not afraid of a little work. Take off your hat and pour a little water, then we'll get those bloody ewes in the yard. Just the dog running through the burrs in the Mitchell, running high on the silver of the night. Well, a dingo is a dog, and a dog is a dingo. The lingo is a, and it is the lingo, just a dog. But you don't know my mother was a dingo, and you don't know I like to howl at the moon.
Thank you.
Big galvanized roofs and monster pipes black, pink and white clouds from a chimney stack, red dust and hawks in the wind out back, and here I am at the Isar. What do you do in a town like the Isar, retrenched at 50, become an old miser, drink yourself blind, say you're none the wiser, sit at home with the race foreman whinge? Just over the hill in his own backyard, the landscape becomes a picture postcard, where the colours are soft but the life is hard, on the stations here at the Isar. Tonight's the night of the rodeo ball, before riders and bull and horses stand tall, while out in the park some black people sprawl and share their money on flagons. There's so much more to be understood before coming out here like Robin Hood. The do-gooders do more harm than good without really knowing the Isar. Through the Leichhardt East, where fool's gold flashes, fossick around for Maltese crosses, flog them off to the tourist buses, see ghost scums under the moon. Some really battle, some make do, the luckier ones make a quid and pull through, some perch at the bar like a cage cockatoo, but that's nothing new at the Isar. And it takes a special kind of girl to stay out here in this rugged world. Keep a dignity when the oaths are hurled. I pay my respects to you. And I'll raise my glass to an outback town, to that weathered spirit that won't back down. It takes the courage of a rodeo clown to stick it out at the Isar. Big galvanized roofs and monster pipes black, pink and white clouds from a chimney stack, red dust and hawks in the wind out back, and here I am at the Isar. Never thought I'd return to this lonely track, but here I am back at the Isar.
Well, after the Isa on a trip, we went through Alice Springs, and of course you don't go to Alice Springs without seeing the Rock. Pastel red to burgundy and spinifex to gold. We've just come out of the Mulga where the plains forever roll. And Albert Namatjira has painted all the scenes. And a shower has changed the luster of his land. And it's raining on the rock. In a beautiful country, and I'm proud to travel this big land like an Aborigine. And it's raining on the rock. What an almighty sight to see. And I'm wishing on a postcard that you were here with me. Everlasting daisies and a beautiful desert rose. Where does their beauty come from? Heaven knows. I could ask the wedge-tail, but he's away too high. I wonder if he understands. It's wonderful to fly, and it's raining on the rock in a beautiful country, and I'm proud to travel this big land like an Aborigine, and it's raining on the rock. What an almighty sight to see. And I'm wishing on a postcard that you were here with me. Cannot be described with a picture, the mesmerizing colors of the Olgas, or the grandeur of the Rock. Uluru has power, and it's raining on the Rock in a beautiful country. And I'm proud to travel this big land like an Aborigine. And it's raining on the rock. What an almighty sight to see. And I'm wishing on a postcard that you were here with me. Called detuning. Well, I think you all know why I wrote this song.
goodbye, Bunyip Bluegum, goodbye, Blinky Bill, and beautiful little Nutsy. I can't believe it, our koalas are all dying. Can it really be a national disaster, a world catastrophe? Oh, shiny little black nose and fluffy little ears, furry little bundle soaking up the tears. Oh, snuggle pot and cuddle pie are crying in the rain, and wombat's gone into his hole and won't come out. Oh, pass the hat around between your friends. There's no time to contemplate. Maybe if we show some love, maybe it's not too late. 'Cause Blinky Bill is dying, cross him off the list. Knock on doors, ring the bell, save the eucalypts. I don't think I could stand the shame, knowing that I could have saved the world from losing something beautiful and good. Oh, pass the hat around between your friends. There's no time to contemplate. Maybe if we show some love, maybe it's not too late. One doctor on the job is hardly enough. One little hospital, wake up Australia. It's our corner of the world, time to pull our weight. What would we tell our children about our little maid? Oh, goodbye Bunyip Bluegum, goodbye Blinky Bill, and beautiful little Nutsy. I can't believe it, our koalas are all dying. Can it really be a national disaster, a world catastrophe? Oh, pass the hat around between your friends. Why don't you join us? There's no time to contemplate. Maybe if we show some love, maybe it's not too late. Everybody sing it now. Oh, pass the hat around between your friends. There's no time to contemplate. Show some love, maybe it's not too late.
Who can whistle now? Take a bow, girls. I too. Mary Kay's and my two daughters, Amy, are here on the... First of all, Amy, this side, the tall one. She's 12. And the 11-year-old Georgie on the other side. Take a bow, girl. Right. Well, I don't know if they'll get in the business or not. Here's a new one. I'm not in the mood for laughing, and I'm not in the mood for blues, and I'm not in the mood for gambling, 'cause I'm not in the mood to lose. I'm in the mood for staying home and kicking off my shoes. Hey, I'm in the mood for loving, and I love you. I'm not in the mood for a party, watching a video, but I'm in the mood for music, as long as it's way down low. Mary, Mary, quite contrary, how does your garden grow? Hey, I'm in the mood
good for making love to you. Here I'm in the mood for making. I'm in the mood for making. I'm in the mood for making love to you. I'm not in the mood for smoking or drinking a bottle of beer, but I'm in the mood for whispering sweet nothings in your ear. Hey there, you with that melting smile, bring your body over here. Hey, I'm in the mood for making love to you. Here I'm in the mood for making. I'm in the mood for making. I'm in the mood for making love to you. Here and I'm in the mood for loving. I'm in the mood for loving. I'm in the mood for loving, and I love you.
Thank you. Folks, everywhere I go, I get followed around by this old drunk, and he's found me all the way here at the Long Yard in Tamworth. And the only thing I can do about it is to let him have a song or two, and that's the way we can get rid of him. So without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, don't give him too much encouragement, but let's welcome on stage Merv Carillon.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. I've had several requests. Unfortunately, the guitar's a bit big. But as I was coming up the stairway tonight, ladies and gentlemen, this nice young lady came up to me and she said, "Excuse me, Mr. Carillon." Oh, I like that. She said, "Excuse me, Mr. Carillon." She said, "I think it'd be possible tonight," she said, "if you could sing 'There's a Redback on the Toilet Seat.'" Yeah. Now, ladies and gentlemen, and tin lids, I have never learnt this song, but I've often sat there thinking about it, you know. You know how you sit there? Any excuse for a bludge? Reading all the graffiti? I was thinking, if only I had a pen, I would have written my own graffiti. I would have. Here he sits, poor old Merv, straining every muscle and every nerve. Anyway, I was sitting there thinking, you know, thinking about this Redback song. And all of a sudden, I realise that all the sympathy goes to the fellow that got bit. What about the poor old Redback? What's he supposed to do, put up an umbrella or what? He probably didn't have one handy. Anyway, I thought to myself, someone should write a song for the poor old Redback.
Yeah, dirty rotten mongrel.
There was a big black on the toilet seat when I was there last night. I didn't see him coming,
and it gave me a hell of a fright. So in sheer desperation, I gave him so much pain that he shot out like a bullet and forgot to pull the chain. There was a big bum on the toilet seat when I was there last night. I didn't see him in the dark, but I found a thing to bite. And now he's up in hospital, a sad and sorry sight. And there'll be no big bum on the toilet seat tomorrow night.
Thanks, Merv. I have written quite a few songs, it seems, about mining towns, and I think they're usually a little bit different to the average town, and a lot of nationalities, etc. And Broken Hill is certainly no exception. Anyone been to Broken Hill? And every second long weekend in January, and they had one this year, and 1988 is the next one. They have this wheelbarrow race from Burra to Broken Hill, 355 kilometres. Teams of six push one wheelbarrow each with about 30 kilos of gear in it. And they're no mugs. They push this barrow under the four-minute mile. Now, five of them sit on the running board and the one on the barrow keeps going until he's a bit puffed and then they change over, see? And when I saw a documentary on this race, I thought I've got to write a song about this because it's so uniquely Australian. And the Americans are going to challenge next time, and I think it's like the poor man's Australia Cup, we might call it, right? Yeah. And anyway, and I've dedicated this song to Pro Hart, of course, who really loves Broken Hill, and I've simply called it "Paint Me a Wheelbarrow." Push a wheelbarrow to Broken Hill. Test your endurance, test your skill. Where the sun is hot and the hills are slow. 10 grand to the winners. Push a wheelbarrow to Broken Hill. Test your endurance, test your skill. With a pick and shovel and an old crowbar. And a billy wrapped up in a blanket. Put your men through the toughest test, half a dozen of the very best. The team to beat is from the west. From Burra through to Broken Hill, you gotta be fit or the heat will kill. The man with the flag and the paint on his shirt loves this town like his mother. Put your wheelbarrow to Broken Hill. Test your endurance, test your skill. Quicker changes up the rise. Keep the driver sober. Paint me a purple billabong where the limbs are hollow but the roots are strong, where the world is peaceful all day long. Oh, paint me a purple billabong where the limbs are hollow but the roots are strong, where the world is peaceful all day long. Paint this country how it feels. A rusty roof, a horse on wheels. Shirts and singlets on the line, little chance of rain. Push a wheelbarrow to Broken Hill. Test your endurance, test your skill. It's gonna get harder every year, stiffer competition. Paint me a pub, it'll suit me fine. A bucket of yabbies and a barrel of wine. Paint me a valley tree down by the mine. Oh, paint me a pub, it'll suit me fine. A bucket of yuppies and a barrel of wine. Paint me a wheelbarrow over the line. There's the Southern Cross, and I've got you. A
kelpie dog and a cockatoo. We're traveling easy with a log or two, and we're on the road, we know. We're feeling light and we're feeling good, with 3 or 4 ton of good firewood. You think we might, and I know we should, make love by the fire glow. The possums live in our roof, but they're right. They tip the scribbly gums at night, and even they have a lover's fight. You know what I mean, I know. I could eat you up, you cheeky thing. I promise tonight that I won't sing. So take my axe and pull my string. We'll let the evening flow. And tomorrow night we'll see the Stanley Costa show. They'll let us in, I'll save a few logs for Joe. Three Rivers Hotel and short of a quid we'll go. Dodging rabbits and roos down the dusty road, we know. Just thinking about the years we've known, how we've learned and how we've grown. We've had our trials, but we couldn't moan. Any case, who wants to know? All is well that ends this way. I love you a little more each day. We're in a dream now, what do you say? We'll take it nice and slow. And tomorrow night we'll see the Stanley Costa show. They'll let us in, I'll save a few logs for Joe. Three Rivers Hotel and short of a quid we'll go. Dodging rabbits and roos down the dusty road, we know. Dodging rabbits and roos down the dusty road, we know. Dodging rabbits and roos down the dusty road, we know.
Did you ever wake up in the morning on the wrong side of the bed, a bit confused and yawning? You go straight out the back to your shed. Yeah, all Australian boys need a shed, a place where he can go, somewhere to clear his head, to think about the things his woman said. Yeah, all Australian boys need a shed, place to learn to read and write, to work on his bike at night, to grow up as he likes, to grow anything under lights, a place to keep his tools, nuts and bolts and drills, to hang a hide, to hide the dryer, to hang to pay the bill. Well, my old shed, she leaks a bit, the roof is caving in, nothing that a bloke can't fix with a few spare sheets of tin. The beams are old, telegraph poles, white ants have eaten out. She creaks and sways on windy days and leans towards the south. And there's a fridge in the corner with a few cans on the ice, and a calendar from the tyre service hangs above the vice. All the pictures so far are easy on the eye, but I've had a sneaky preview and I can't wait for July. Yeah, all Australian boys need a shed. At the back of the shed where the dogs are fed, near last year's bales are loosened. Sticky tall green weeds came up with thrown out seeds. All it took was bantam poop, I watered them once and they grew some. Should be prime about Easter time, even though nosy neighbour steals them. Yeah, all Australian boys need a shed. To weld up broken gates, a place for all his mates, to come round Sunday arvo for a jam. A place to make a racket, find the pipe and pack it, to think about the things his woman said. Yeah, all Australian boys need a shed. Yeah, all Australian boys need a shed. Yeah, all Australian boys need a shed.
Thank you. Thanks very much. Actually, I'll set this next song up because I really want to make up to the girls now. With a song written especially for the mums, and the dads can listen too. It's simply called the Cootamundra Wattle. Don't go looking through that old camphor box, woman. You know those old things only make you cry. When you dream upon that little bunny rug, makes you think that life has passed you by. There are days when you wish the world would stop, woman, but then you know some wounds would never heal. But when I browse the early pages of the children, then I know exactly how you feel. Hey, it's July and the winter sun is shining, and the Cootamundra wattle is my friend. For all at once my childhood never left me, 'cause wattle blossoms bring it back again. It's Sunday and you should stop the worry, woman. Come out here and sit down in the sun. Can't you hear the magpies in the distance? Don't you feel the new day has begun? Can't you hear the bees making honey, woman? In the spotted gums where the bellbirds ring. You might grow old and bitter 'cause you missed it. You know some people never hear such things. Hey, it's July and the winter sun is shining, and the Cootamundra wattle is my friend. For all at once my childhood never left me, 'cause wattle blossoms bring it back again. Don't buy the daily papers anymore, woman. Read all about what's going on in hell. They don't care to tell the world of kindness. Good news never made a paper sell. There's all the colours of the rainbow in the garden, woman, and symphonies of music in the sky. Heaven's all around us if you're looking, but how can you see it if you cry? Hey, it's July and the winter sun is shining, and the Cootamundra wattle is my friend. For all at once my childhood never left me, 'cause wattle blossoms bring it back again.
Where the girls can have a bit of a laugh at the fellow this time.
Huh?
Anyone here tonight had a vasectomy? There's an honest chappy back. Oh, he looks a bit young. You all know what a vasectomy is? Where a fella goes to the doctor's firing on all fours, and he comes out shooting blanks, right? Well, my mate reckoned he was a bit conned. He didn't fully understand what the operation was all about, but he said that was okay. He said afterwards he had to offer the doctor a little sample to see if there's any life left in him. So I thought there's got to be a song here. It's just the modern world we live in, but why do they pick on me? Well, just the other week, my missus had the cheek to talk me into a vasectomy. At first it never clicked that I was getting nicked. I thought it was to test virility. Then after I went through it, 10 days we couldn't do it. And then the doctor said to me, I couldn't believe it, folks. He said, please blow into this bag, please, sir.
What?
To test your capability.
Beg your pardon?
We're cutting down on accidents. I said, are you fair dinkum? He said, please blow into this bag and we'll see. Well, I couldn't believe it at first. But you know what they say about doctor's orders? So he gave me this little bag and ushered me into this little room with all the pin-ups on the walls. Oh, not bad either, look at that. Reminded me of my shed. Well, I got the message and around about an hour and a half later, I came back in my little bag and the doctor was quite satisfied. And he wasn't the only one. It's just the modern world we live in. There's newfangled things every day. The cop said I was speeding according to his reading, but I was 3 kilometres away. I was feeling pretty mad when he took out his pad. I tried to stay as calm as I could be. He found a baldy tread and he saw my eyes were red. And then he said this strange thing to me. I said, what again? He said, please blow into this bag, please, sir. I said, what? To test your capability.
I beg your pardon?
We're cutting down on accidents. I said, you fiddick, please blow into this bag and we'll see. Well, this time I was really shaken up. And the cop could see I was a bit excited. He said, well, you better take a good grip on yourself, son. So I went around behind a big gum tree. You should have seen the look on the lizard's face. I came back with my little bag. Well, you can imagine what happened. It's just a modern world living. I'm feeling very sad and pale. The judge said I was sick and threw me in the nick, and my missus said she wouldn't pay the bail. So take it from a fool like me, beware of quacks and boys in blue. I'm feeling pretty bruised, so don't you get confused. I'd catch a train if I was you. All together now, please blow into this bag, please, oh. It sends a shiver down the spine. Please blow into this bag, please, oh. If the women don't get you, it's the wine.
Now I'm going to pay tribute for one of the first Australian country singers that was unashamed of his Aussie accent. So would you welcome on stage, ladies and gentlemen, the legendary Chad Morgan.
Yeah. mother said, I think I'm handsome. Their father think I'm mad. Their mother think I'm a villain. But I'm just a lovable lad. I'm loved by the poor and the wealthy. I'm loved by the good and the bad. I'm loved by the fat and the skinny. Because I'm a lovable lad. Now I've been chased by fathers with shotguns of all kinds. And you can tell where they have been by the marks that's left behind. I don't know why they do it, cause I'm not really bad. I just chase their daughters because I'm a lovable lad. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. It's nice to be here in the Long Yard. And we reckon he's going to have a short yard out the back. He's going to do a show on the back of a ute. Anyway, we've been around a bit this year and in some of the cola areas. Recently visited Orange. It was interesting, performing to all the Orange people. It's an unusual town. Then I saw three or four Orange Aborigines walking up the main street. Thought you might be interested to know that my original name was Chadwick. I thought I might tell you how I ended up to be called Chad. Well, I got a job very early at around about the age of 15 up on the cane farm, you see. And I got on pretty well with the boss's daughter, you know. And he caught us one day in the cane field and he flew with his big cane knife and cut the wig off and it's been Chad ever since. But she was a beautiful girl, she really was. She was really nice. She had these beautiful blue eyes. One blew that way and the other one blew that way. And she had this long black hair. Oh, gee whiz, I'll never forget. Hanging out of her left nostril. And I used to call her Polly because she waffled on all the time. Anyway, I'm only allowed to do one more song, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. And I'm only allowed to do it because it's a young Johnny Williamson song, you know, it's a wacko's, this shower space. And it's all about the bachelor and spinster's balls I have out in the bush. Where they all wear evening gowns and dinner suits, you know, and all that sort of real posh stuff and throw a groggle on one another and all that. And it's all about a blind date and it's called the Waratah Rock and Roll Ball. It's a top song. There's a clock tick-tock, tock, tick-tick, talking on the wall. And I've got a blind date for the Waratah Rock and Roll Ball. But I can't find my shoes and I hear those rock and roll songs. I can't wear a dinner suit with a worn-out pair of thongs. I found me pointy-toed cowboy boots made with crocodile skin. And I twisted and strained to get my big feet in. And I was thinking of the girl, was she nice, and you know, what was my chance? When I tore the crutch right out of my brand new pants. So I pulled on my jeans and my thongs and I said, what the heck? If they don't let us in, I'll take her to the discotheque. So I'm walking up a driveway feeling like a boy in his teens. When this big mongrel dog tears the right leg off of me jeans. Come get out, you big ugly little bastard. I'll pee off. So with blood on my shin and my right knee sticking out, I rang on a door, determined to take her out. Well, you should have seen the size of the bloke that answered the bell.
He said, "I shall come and see what thinks is going to take out a little girl."
How you going on? Been a nice drop of rain? I like your little puppy dog. When I shrank to the size of a dog and I lowered my tail and I faded into the shadows, sad and pale. Whether there's a moral to the story, mate, be a sport and let me know. Meanwhile, I'll just go home and tune me fiddle and rosin me bow.
Here's a song, folks, that won me a gold guitar in Tamworth this year, and it's called You and My Guitar. This guitar only sings the way I play it. It's a part of me just like another arm. It started out as a little ukulele when I was just a boy on the farm. My fingers were too lazy for piano, but I could hold a tune pretty good. And I couldn't sing a song with a trombone, so I taught myself to play this piece of wood. But I know you are staying beside me. True lovers, we both feel the pain. And I'd throw this old box on the fire before I'd ever lose you again. Well, you never did like this old guitar, did you, darling? 'Cause the guitar takes your man away from you. One day I'll write a song for you, darling. It'll be the very best that I can do. Will it be a song about a wild wind with a thunderclap and flashes of blue? Oh, will it be a song about an angel? It'll never be as beautiful as you. But I know you are staying beside me. True lovers, we both feel the pain. I throw this old box on the fire before I never lose you again. This guitar only sings the way I play it. It's a part of me just like another arm. It started out as a little ukulele. I was just a boy on the farm. But now I am a man with a woman. The words I want to say won't come through. No matter where this guitar's gonna take us, it'll never be as beautiful as you.
In the finest harbour in the world, in a cove they call them Sydney, the Captain Governor Philip Trimdy sails. With shelter from the winds and the big Pacific Ocean, we landed in New South Wales. And you should see the parrots, all coloured in like rainbows, wallabies and screeching cockatoos. And a bird that won't stop laughing when he sees me getting a flogging, he wouldn't be laughing if he was in my shoes. You beat your drum, you drink your rum, you threaten me with hanging. It's difficult with a chain around me ankle. But given half a chance, I'd break and disappear in the grey gums and learn to live like a native in this land. And the native blacks are friendly, even though a bit suspicious of anyone with a red coat or a gun. If I can learn their lingo and listen to the dream time, the bush and me and the animals would be one. And my convict mates all hate the place, they long for Mother England, but what in the hell has she got, I declare? The chimneys are a-smoking, the smelly and a-choking, and the jukes are in every bunny rabbit there. And the Irish girl I lay with in the middle of the ocean, she said she's willing and keen to marry me. Working like a dog and treated like a donkey, given 10 years or so I might be free. And you beat your drum, you drink your rum, you threaten me with hanging. It's difficult with a chain around me ankle. But given half a chance, I'd break and disappear in the grey gums and learn to live like a native in this land. And you beat your drum, you drink your rum, you threaten me with hanging. It's difficult with a chain around me ankle. But given half a chance, I'd break and disappear in the grey gums and learn to live like a native in this land.
Thank you.
And I can't feel those chains any longer, can you? I'm footloose and free. I can't see the sense in red, white and blue. It's still Union Jack to me. We're drifting in the ocean alone now, like a beautiful ship at sea. And I can't feel those chains any longer. I love this big country. So I'll raise my glass to the diggers, jump like a kangaroo, stare them in the eye like an emu. I'll always be true blue. Have you ever spoken to a gum tree? What am I trying to say to you? Love this place as half as much as I do, and you're a true blue too. Hey, I can't feel this change any longer, can you? I'm footloose and free. Can't see the sense in red, white and blue. Still Union Jack to me. We're drifting in the ocean alone now, like a beautiful ship at sea. And I can't feel those chains any longer. I love this big country. So come on, let's get on with the shearing. Make a little wool and wine. No gold at the end of the rainbow. There's no fruit without the vine. We're gonna be fed income, cause that's the way it has to be. Or there won't be enough to build a doghouse. Won't you sing this song with me? I'll raise my glass to the diggers, jump like a kangaroo, stare them in the eye like an emu. I'll always be true blue. Have you ever spoken to a gum tree? What am I trying to say to you? Love this place as half as much as I do, and you're a true blue too. Hey! Glory to Australia.
glory to the green and gold. We've come a long way, says Botany Bay, and we're nearly 200 years old. Hey, glory to Australia, glory to the green and gold. We've come a long way, says Botany Bay, and we're nearly 200 years old. I've been around the world a couple of times or maybe more. I've seen the sights, I've had delights on every foreign shore. But when my mates all ask me the place that I adore, I tell them right away. What do we tell them? Give me a home among the countries with lots of plum trees, a sheep or two, a kangaroo, a clothesline out the back, veranda out the front, and an old rocking chair. You can see me in the kitchen cooking up a roast, or Vegemite on toast, just you and me, a cup of tea. Later on we'll settle down and mull up on the porch and watch the possums play. Give me a home among the gum trees with lots of plum trees, a sheep or two, a kangaroo, a clothesline out the back, veranda out the front, an old rocking chair. There's a Safeway's up the corner and the Woolies down the street, and a brand new place they've opened up, but they regulate the heat. But I trade them all tomorrow for a little bush retreat with a Kookaburra's hawk. Give me a home among the country with lots of plum trees, a sheep, a two, a kangaroo, a clothesline out the back, veranda out the front, and an old rocking chair. Some people like their houses with fences all around, others live in mansions and some beneath the ground. For me, I like the bush, you know, with rabbits running round and a pumpkin vine out the back. This is your turn. Give me a home. Give me a home among the gum trees with lots of plum trees, a sheep, a two, a kangaroo, a clothesline out the back, veranda out the front, and an old rocky.
I reckon one of the greatest songs written in this land, if not in the world, is this one right here. When I was a young man, I carried a pack. I lived the free life of a rover. From the Murray's Green Basin to the dusty outback, I waltzed my Matilda all over. Then in 1915, my country said, son, there's no time for roving, there's work to be done. And they gave me a tin hat, and they gave me a gun, and they sent me away to the war. And the band played Waltzing Matilda as our ship pulled away from the quay. And amidst all the cheers, the flag waving and tears, we set off for Gallipoli. How well I remember that terrible day when our blood stained the sand and the water, and how in that hell that they call Suvla Bay, we were butchered like lambs at the slaughter.
Johnny Turkey was waiting, he primed himself well. Shot us with bullets and he rained us with shells, and in 5 minutes flat, well, he blew us to hell. He nearly blew us right back to Australia. And the band played Waltzing Matilda as we stopped to bury our slain. We buried ours and the Turks buried theirs. Then we started all over again. So those who were left just tried to survive in a mad world of blood, death and fire. And for 10 weary weeks I kept myself alive as the corpses around me piled higher. Then a big Turkish shell knocked me ass overhead, and when I awoke in the hospital bed, I saw what it had done and I wished I was dead. Then I knew there were worse things than dying, and I'll go no more waltzing Matilda all through the green bush far and free. 'Cause to hunt and tent peg a man needs both legs. No more waltzing Matilda for me. They collected the crippled, the wounded, the maimed, shipped us all back to Australia. The legless, the armless, the blind and insane, the brave wounded heroes of Suvla. And as our ship pulled into Circular Quay, I looked at the place where my legs used to be, and I thank Christ there was nobody waiting for me to mourn and to grieve and to pity. And the band played a waltzing Matilda as they carried us down the gangway. Nobody cheered, they just stood and stared, then turned all their faces away. And now every April I sit on the porch as I watch the parade pass before me. I see my old comrades, how proudly they march, reviving old dreams and past glories. But the old men march slowly, bones stiff and sore, tired old men from a tired old war. And the young people ask, what are they marching for? And I ask myself the same question. And the band plays Waltzing Matilda as the old men still answer the call. And year after year more old men disappear. Soon none of them will march there at all.
Thanks a lot, folks. You've been a fantastic audience. And this song I'd like to finish with is a song that I wrote hoping that it would inspire Aussies to stand up for themselves and to fight for independence and to fight for esteem. And if you sing along with this chorus, the stronger you sing, we may, with a bit of luck, just bring down the spirit of the great Ned Kelly. Hey, true blue, don't say you've gone.
Say you've knocked off for a smoker, and you'll be back later on, hey true blue, hey true blue, give it to me straight, face to face. Are you really disappearing, just another dying race? Hey true blue, true blue, is it me and you? Is it mom and dad? Is it a cockatoo? Is it standing by your mate when he's in a fight? Or just Vegemite? True blue, I'm asking you, hey true blue, can you bear the load? Will you tie it up with wire just to keep the show on the road? Hey true blue, join me this time, come on. True blue, is it me and you? Is it me and you? Is it mum and dad? Is it mum and dad? Is it a cockatoo? Is it a cockatoo? Is it standing by your mate? Is it standing by your mate when she's in a fight? Or just Vegemite? True blue, I'm asking you, true blue,
come on sing up now.
Is it me and you? Is it mom and dad? Is it a cockatoo? Is it standing by your mate when he's in a fight? Or just Vegemite? True blue, I'm asking you, true blue.
Let's hear for Ned now.
Is it me and you? Is it mom and dad? Is it a cockatoo? It is standing by your mate when he's in a fight, or just Vegemite? True blue, true blue.
Just before I recorded this song, I discovered a sound on this little instrument here called a Jew's harp. It's also been nicknamed a Jaws harp. We had one in the family when I was a kid.
¶¶
How's it going now? Keep it up now.
Let me tell you, I'm an interview with an old man in you. He's got a beak and feathers and teeth, but the poor old fella ain't got no wing. Aren't you jealous of a witch tail eagle? Ba-da-da-da-da-da. The eagle's flying round and round to keep a 2 feet firmly on the ground. Now I can't fly, but I'm telling you, I can run the pants of a kangaroo. But I he can't fly, but I'm telling you, I can run the pants of a kangaroo. Well, he was the model for the 50 cents. The designer should have had more sense. You take a look, it'll prove to you. I ran the pants of that kangaroo. Take a look, it'll prove to you. He ran the pants of a kangaroo. You can't loop the loo like a cockatoo. Swerve and toss like an albatross. Silly galah, a bit of boy fun than a white cockatoo or a budgerigar. Squeak and squawk and try and talk. I mean, them's not tease and talk. But that a dee he come live, but I'm telling you, I can run the band of a kangaroo. Well, the last time I saw old man, he knew him, da-da-da-da-da-da. He was chasing a female, he knew him, da-da-da-da-da-da. As he shot past, I heard him say, she can't fly, but I'm telling you, she can run her knickers off a kangaroo. But I don't need. She can't fly, but I don't need. She can run the band of a kangaroo. Well, there is a moral to this ditty. Rush can sing, but he ain't pretty. Duck can swim, but he can't sing. Nor can the eagle on the beam. You can't fly, but I'm telling you, he can run the pants of a kangaroo. But the Wookaburra laughed and he said, it's true.
Once was a jolly swagman camped by a billabong under the shade of the coolibah tree, and he sang as he watched and waited till his billy boiled. You come a waltzing Matilda, let's hear it now.
Waltzing Matilda, Matilda, my darling,
you come a waltzing Matilda with me. And he sang as he watched and waited till his billy boiled. Come a waltzing Matilda with me.
That's right, you join the last line each time.
Down came the chumbug to drink and the billabong. I've got the swaggy and grabbed him with glee. And he sang as he stowed that chumbug in his tucker bag. You come a waltzing Matilda with me. Come on, sing it.
Waltzing Matilda, Matilda, my darling.
Come a waltzing Matilda with me. And he sang as he stowed that shumbuck in his saddlebag. You come a waltzing Matilda with me.
Okay, next chorus I want to hear blokes only, all right?
Down came the squatter mounted on his thoroughbred. Up came the troopers.
One, two, three.
Who's a jolly chumbuck you've got in your tucker bag? You come a waltzing Matilda with me. Let's hear it now.
Blokes only.
Matilda, Matilda, my darling. You come a waltzing Matilda.
Who's the jolly jumper?
Who's the jolly jumper?
Let's hear it for the boys, girls. Come on. So your turn next, girls. Now, fellas, listen to them. It's no competition. But it really is a pleasure to hear a whole bunch of Aussie girls singing along with Waltz and Matilda. Next chorus.
I've got the swaggy and jumped into the billabong. You'll never catch me alive, said he.
This line you got to remember.
And his ghost may be heard as you pass by that billabong. You come home. The girls, only this time.
And she goes, Doesn't that sound fantastic? All together now.
Waltz, Matilda, Matilda, my darling. Waltzing Matilda with me. And his ghost may be heard as you pass by that billabong.
See you along the road of song, folks.
You'll come a Matilda with me.
Thanks a lot, folks. Thank you. You said you'd never go away. You said you never would. If I could only make you stay, I wish I damn well could. You don't make me feel bad. You make me feel real good. And I hope to see you next time. And don't forget to say hello, cause I'll remember you. Hope you had a good time, had a laugh or two. Don't you do anything that I wouldn't do. And I hope to see you next time. So hooroo Tamworth, up the road I burn. Just like a boomerang, I shall return. We're all God's people as far as I'm concerned. And I hope to see you next time. Cause I hope to see you next time. Cause I hope to see you next time.
Good night, folks. Drive carefully. Thank you.
Thanks very much for coming along. Thank you.
John Williamson has a wide range of merchandise available by mail order. To obtain a brochure or further information, please telephone 02 868 3888 or write to PO Box 399 Epping 2121.